the Pulpmx Show, presented by BTOsports.com. Coming to you live from Las Vegas, right outside the Lion's Den, with your host, Steve Mathis. And now strap in and get ready. It's showtime.
I just don't like the guy. The guy's just a douchebag.
Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah. Welcome, everybody. The Pulpmx Show, presented by BTOsports.com and Fly Racing. Coming at you. It's show 300, everybody. I can't believe we made it. Good God. 300 episodes. I started the show in 2010, and it's 2017, and we're stoked. Happy to bring you a great jam-packed studio lineup, maybe one that's never been topped in Pulpmx Show history. And thank you, everybody, for listening. We appreciate it. Please check out the sponsor deals on pulpmxshow.com. Check out the app. You can get it as well. Patreon, Stitcher carries the show. If you want to help us out with some server costs, a new site is coming. That's all on board on Patreon. And also, too, please subscribe on iTunes and leave us a review. Leave us a little note, especially after tonight. You guys are probably going to love it. We thank you again for listening. We'll take your phone call, 702-586-7857. And, yeah, we're going to have some fun tonight. A little bit of high point talk, a lot of down memory load, road talk. So just get ready for that. BTOsports.com, Fly Racing, NFAB Jeep and Truck Parts, Racetech Suspension and Engines, Vortex Racing, Gear Alloy, Roost MX, Pivot Works, X-Brand Goggles, Michelin Star Cross 5, Works Connection, FMF, Atlas Neck Brace, W Wheels, EK Chains, Guts Racing, Get Data, Ride Engineering, Grant Stone Boots, all on board with us tonight, as are you. And also, too, thanks to everybody on RacerX Facebook Live page. What's up, everybody? Thanks for watching. We're going to put this up on YouTube as well, on Pulpmx channel, so you can get it on there. And, yeah, it's awesome. Let's get right into our guests. Like I said, jam-packed studio. I can't believe I got these guys here. I cannot believe it all worked out. It was amazing, the effort that went into it, but they're here. Legends of the sport. First up, he's our regular, semi-regular co-host, our favorite Frenchman, 14 Supercross and Motocross wins, David Vuillemin. What's up, DV? How are you?
What's up?
Welcome back to the studio.
I'm back.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Exciting day.
It sounds like it. You're a little down, though, from the tables.
Yeah, from everything, I'm down.
is this going to affect your mood tonight?
Yeah, I'm not happy about it, but, you know, I'll get through it.
Also here, this man, he's a three-time national and Supercross champion, four-time if you count the 125 East Coast, 61 Supercross and Motocross wins. He's a legend, an icon. Chad Reed, what's up, Chad?
What's up, Mathis?
How are you?
I'm well. How about you?
Thank you for coming in.
No worries.
Really surprised you agreed to do it.
Really?
Yeah, but it's good. It's awesome.
I don't understand why everyone's so surprised.
you know what? You're not that busy right now, though. Supercross is over.
I'm bored as hell.
Right.
I am
right.
Bored as hell.
Also in studio, the true star of the event, 5 Supercross and Motocross wins, and a 125 East Coast Championship, the Red Dog, Tim Ferry. What's up, Red? Oh, wait. There you go. How are you?
I'm good.
Thanks for coming in.
Cut right off.
No problem.
Yeah? You worked with Trey Kennard today? He's coming back soon?
Yeah, I was in Lake Elsinore today and then drove straight here.
And you are wide open right now.
Yeah. I'm Tony Alessi, as you would say.
You are. You really are. Producing the show, holding things down over there in the corner. He's making things happen. The Travis Marks. What's up, Marks?
Yo.
Happy 300.
Hey, we made it.
Somehow.
I've been here for like 40.
40?
I don't know. Probably more than that.
The other guy was here before?
A couple guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
A lot of them.
I'm holding it down, though.
Yeah, you are.
I'm producer of the year.
We are going to give away a Fly Racing F2 carbon helmet tonight. That's right. Folks at Fly Racing stepping up. We're just going to give one away to somebody, a lucky caller, at some point. And we have 12 tickets to Muddy Creek, courtesy of the folks at Pivot Works as well. We'll do some of those by email at contest@pulpmxshow.com and some of them on our phone calls as well. So if you have a question for Chad Reed, David Vuillemin, Tim Ferry, 702-586-7857, show 100. We reunited the Great Western Bank team, Stevenson, Lawrence, Castillo, Antonez. Show 200, we got all the old co-hosts, Paul Lindsay, Kenny Watson, Chris Kiefer, we're in, and 300 here is the factory Yamaha Dream Team, Ferry, Reed, and Vuillemin. What should I do for 400? What do you guys think? What should 400 be?
If I'm still racing.
he might still be racing.
If I'm still, I might be busy.
Can you believe Red Dog, this guy's still racing? Like,
I honestly, I can't. I really can't.
DV,
he's outlasting still racing. A lot of us.
You've been gone forever.
Yeah, I don't want to get into this. I don't know why.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I was over it at 30, so it's kind of
the scary thing is like retiring kind of scares me even still.
Right, like what are you gonna do?
It's
right?
The best thing you'll ever do. That's what people don't understand.
That is not true. I follow everything you do. It doesn't look that fun.
Rooftop
to me.
Hollywood, bro.
Yeah, rooftop Hollywood. You're single now.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter, really. You can be retired and be family and same thing, you know? I have my kids half of the time, so.
We got one guy that's racing and training and gnarly, still going at it.
Not training. Let's leave the training out.
We got one guy that is busier than he ever was was racing. You're training four riders, right? And your two kids, Beckett and Evan, are racing and riding now. Evan's going to Loretta Lynn's. You were supposed to go. Not doing it.
Yeah, backed out the last second.
Oh, you backed out?
Were you scared of Mike Brown?
I did watch him ride, and he is really fast still. I really was just too busy.
What about Robbie Rennan?
What happened to that 65 pounds? 165, I thought we talked about.
Yeah, I'm working on it still. I had time for Loretta's.
When was that? At a party or something?
You said you were getting
my kid's party. He tells me, I'm going to drop down to 163 and get ready for Loretta's. it's over.
So it is. You're busier than ever. He's still racing professionally, and this guy does nothing. Literally nothing.
Well, that's a fine. Should
that's
we
a
find
fine. That's a fine. That's a fine.
No, nothing. No, I have stuff to do. I'm a dad 50% of the time. First of all.
50% of the time. The guys that are 100% of the time are laughing right now.
And Chad's got one more kid that
it's,
I do.
It's so. A figure of speech, you know.
Your kids take care of themselves at this point.
No.
Billy's
have him,
a good dad.
And
I see.
I have him, like, on my own, though. You know, it's like just me. So.
Which is gnarly.
So, you know.
Yeah.
That's what I do.
I'd rather split with my wife than have him 50% of the
time. I'm with
it's
Red.
Like, you know. I cook, I do laundry, I do all this regular day job thing, you know? But, you know, I don't want to ride.
Without the job.
You guys like to ride or you like to go to...
That's what we should do for the 400 show. We should go all ride together.
What about...
Get Vuillemin in some gear.
I just don't like riding. I don't like motocross. I never liked it anyway, so...
I never liked it.
Hey, for Travis, for not liking motocross, he has a lot of opinions about motocross.
He
watches it all the time, too.
I'm into it because I'm a fan. But being an actor, I didn't like it. I didn't like it was hard and it was, like, tough. You get hurt. It's, you know... Czech was good. It was really good. But other than that, I think it's tough.
Why don't we look? You and the Christian Craig thing didn't work out. Why don't you?
Nothing I do works out. So
why don't you get in with the 22? Remember when Apollo trained Rocky? They were once bitter rivals.
And then one of them died.
While Apollo,
you're gonna die, DD.
We don't want to do that.
If I'm Rocky, I'm good.
Yeah. No, you be Rocky.
Okay,
and
good.
Then you're
so I die. Somehow I'm going to die somewhere.
So you come back and you get with 2-2 and
you
train him.
Just make it quick.
Right.
Make it quick.
So you need to work on tire pressure, momentum in corners.
I got to set my fork pressure.
Just shut up and ride.
Hey, take it off the stand and then take the air out of it.
Right. It is pretty amazing that he's still racing, though.
It really is.
It is amazing.
Well, I mean, I think me and him could go race right now, but it's at the level, you know.
Well, that's
that
what
racing
no.
at.
Yeah, he's.
Yeah, he's at.
He got a podium this year.
At the top.
Yeah, he has a potential. So there's something like. Right now, I can even. I don't know. Can
I
be?
I was also. I was the kid when we were all teammates. So.
Yeah, no, you were, which is funny, and we'll get into that. You know, Chad came into the team. You guys have been there for a couple of years. Everything was cool. And then this guy comes and shows up and
I was the third wheel.
Revving the shit out of his bike in the air, scaring everybody.
He doesn't put his bike on a stand. He doesn't want to.
Still don't.
He doesn't want to wear only blue gear.
Yeah, you guys wear blue gear. No problem, Keith.
No problem.
We'll do it.
Send the check. It's fine. All right, blue gear. I wear pink gear if you want.
Yeah. I'm kind of with DV. I don't care either.
Right. And then this
guy's colorblind. That's true.
I'm also colorblind, so.
See? Yeah, there's your reason.
I didn't even know.
Great. So thanks, everybody, for listening. We really appreciate it. 702-586-7857. You got a question for one of these guys. We're going to the BTOsports.com tweet at Travis, where we got our listeners who sent questions in. We got the NFAB question, NFAB JGR check-in. We have a Gear Alloy cold call. We have the Truck Hero cold call. Sorry, Gear Alloy cold call. Truck Hero question of the day, X Brown goggle tear offs, Race Tech email segment as well, all coming up. Also, too, Chad Reed's appearance on the show. He uses only one sprocket, people. It's a Vortex. Did you know that?
I did.
Okay. Vortex Racing bringing you Chad Reed on the show. Cooper Webb, Chad Reed, they use Vortex Racing sprockets. The Babbitts Cowie team uses Vortex bars as well as the sprockets. And so email Jake at vortexracing.com to save big at Vortex Racing. And Chad Reed brought to you by Vortex, and we thank those guys tonight. So, hey, I think at some point we're going to call Jimmy Perry, our old manager, team manager of the year.
Is he aware of this?
Kind of. Team manager of the year.
This is maybe the 10-minute window that I wish I was retired. Or maybe just not currently under his...
Okay, are you going to race next year? You're going to race next year, right?
That's the plan, yes.
And you had probably your most frustrating
year ever.
Year at Cowie was worse?
Yeah, it was the same.
Kind of, right? I mean...
It was worse in the fact that I got hurt, but yeah.
You won Hangtown that year.
Yeah.
So that was good on Cowie, but other than that... So once again, we're going to see Chad Reed. Can he bring it again? Can he bring back the magic 1 year?
And, I think I can.
I don't think you'd be racing if you didn't think you could, right? Are you going to stay with Yamaha? Do we know? Is it negotiations? Are we...
We are just trying to figure out what's going on, really, to be honest with you.
Yeah, so we're not really sure where we're going
to
go.
Maybe we can get Jimmy on the phone and talk to him about it.
Yeah, let's ask Jimmy about it. Let's put him on the spot.
It was a very entertaining. It was a very unique year for you. We had some great rides, and then some rides where you were like, is that the same guy we know? And then, of course, we had the Dungy incident, and then we had other times where you were crashing, which for you was really weird to see you crash so much.
I crashed 5 weeks. No, actually 5 times in 4 weeks exiting the whoops. My strongest point in the racetrack.
Yeah, and so sometimes we'd be sitting in the stands going, that's odd.
Try sitting on the bike.
Right, yeah, no thanks. Yeah. No thanks. So we'll get into all that and more. And again, Timmy, you got Loretta's coming up. So that's, and you're working with Kennard, Mel Ross, Marty.
Your buddy.
You got him on the show.
I did.
Hey, does he?
He hasn't said another word since it.
Does he send you pictures?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. Here we go. I just
want to clear things out.
And then some amateur kids?
None of himself. Yep. Anyway.
I'm busy.
You are, man. You are so busy.
I like busy, though.
I live 5 minutes from Red, and I never see him.
Not unless it's a kid's birthday party.
Yeah, that's kid's it. Birthday party, and that's about
five of
Wait,
them together.
You were going to ride at his place a little bit at some point?
Yeah.
Was that a while ago?
Was that a long time ago?
I think you went and took Evan over, I think.
Did you?
Oh, actually, I went and rode over there.
Yeah,
oh.
Maybe.
I had a day off. I went and rode by myself.
My track's, like, no track at my house is rideable right now.
Okay.
It's, like, my... You good? You with us?
DB, he said silence the phones.
Silence the phones, DB.
My outdoor track's rained out. Supercross track's rained out.
Yeah,
my go-kart track's probably pretty good.
I haven't seen anybody ride that thing in at least 5 years.
Yeah. The go-kart track?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe more.
Yeah, that was...
Great radio, bros.
That was a drop.
That wasn't me. It's a drop.
Like I said, we're going to give away 12 tickets to Muddy Creek, courtesy of Pivot Works, and the Fly F2 carbon helmet as well. So we'll get into some more Yamaha talk and everything else. Two stroke, four strokes.
Oh, yeah.
Three strokes.
That was a battle for a while. At one point, Timmy, you and Chad didn't like each other. At one point, DV, you and Chad didn't like each other. He turned the sprinklers on you.
It was very brief.
Did you and DV ever have any problems or no?
No. Okay. How could you not like DV?
I don't think we ever, even on the track.
We'll talk about all your wins in Supercross, Red.
Pontiac 02. We got to talk about that one.
Half a lap to go.
Was that just before the tunnel, right?
That switchback into the
exit of the loops.
Hey, so let's talk a little bit of the Nationals right now, what we got going on right now. And so right now, Baggett won two in a row. Tomac has won the most motos, but he's also made the most mistakes. Chad, we'll start with you. What do you think of the 450 class right now? We're waiting on Tomac. He was supposed to go 20 and 4. You know, he's
20 and 4.
Yeah, 20 wins, 4 losses. He's supposed to do Roczen last year. We all thought it's not happening.
Yeah,
and Baggett's on fire.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think I'm the hottest one to probably make that comment just because I'm current. Uh-huh. You know, like, I for sure have my own opinion on the class.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I mean, you know, the same mistake that Eli made that lost him a Supercross title is seemingly what's costing him race wins in motocross right now. I mean, mm-hmm. And I think he made a comment, at least when I watched the race on the app this weekend.
Yeah.
You know, he seems to be having an issue where he's losing the front and seemingly in pretty – you know, like basic turns and
yep.
kind of catching him off guard. He had a pretty similar crash at Hangtown, but, it, you know, was still able to win. So, yeah, I mean, I think that he has some issues that he's, you know, maybe fighting and trying to figure out. Talking to you earlier, it sounds like maybe they went with a rear tire that made things interesting and then
yep.
went back for the second moto. And so, you know, I think it's Eli's title still to lose. I just think that he's the guy that can get it done, but he's proving that he's not getting it done also right now, so I don't know.
For the fans and the media covering it, Baggett's comments have been great. I don't have a famous father. I ate Cold Stone Bakery on Friday before the race in Lakewood. You want to ride behind him and break him. He talked about Eli at Lakewood. This is great.
Yeah, I think it makes it fun for you guys, but I think that, for me, I find it fun because that's the game you used to play, you know? And
yeah.
I remember I used to say, I play golf all the time, you know, like I won 6 in a row at the end of 03 with Ricky, and it was all about going and playing golf and not riding and training. But the truth was is I was training my ass off harder than ever and
right.
riding in the mornings. Yeah, maybe
yeah.
Played golf in the afternoon, but Blake's doing the work. Blake's working harder than he's ever worked. Maybe he's having an ice cream here and there, but
right.
that's normal.
Yeah, you don't win if you're not putting in the work.
No, right. And I think that they're, you know, let's make those comments after, you're a champion, yeah. necessarily right. One win.
Yeah, DV, what do you think of all that? What do you think of the battle between Baggett and talk about Marvin? Is he going to be able to, in meniscus, Roger DeCoster said it was a meniscus, so he needs to have a surgery at some point to clip it, right? But
You don't have to. You can finish the season like this, but you don't want to tweak it again. He's going to it could take like from 2 to a month to get back 100% from a surgery. It's a small surgery, but, you know, meniscus is kind of sketchy at one point. I have mine done. I was talking about it before the show, and I think it took almost a month to feel actually decent to ride. So I doubt he's going to get it done. If it does, I think he won't be able to.
Like, is this
to finish or?
Like, is this the end? Not the end, but is this?
If he wants to keep a chance in there, he shouldn't talk about surgery. Just deal with it.
Yeah.
You know.
He had a decent second moto. 6 was good.
Yeah,
like,
6,
you know.
And you could see ride him like on the peg standing up. He actually rode pretty good.
Second moto, he rode
yeah.
much better. First,
I think
moto,
he had adapted himself.
Yeah.
Okay,
well,
why is that? Did painkillers come in or something?
No, I think
okay.
the track dried up a lot. And I think second moto, I mean, it's not like he lost his fitness. You know,
no,
it's
yeah.
just he just had a sore knee. And second moto, everyone else drops off. And he actually looked like he was charging in the second moto, at least when I watched.
But it was kind of smooth, like with
yeah.
feet on the pegs, and
yeah.
you could see like his left leg. He wasn't putting his leg out. And that's the thing with the knee. You always think about,
mm-hmm.
you know, I don't have ACL since 1991 in my knee. And every right turn that I took in my whole career, I thought about my knee, which is weird.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that track didn't look like a fun
yeah,
track to ride
no.
with a sore knee. I mean,
so that's, and that's, you know, what he's going to have to do, you know. So, I think just deal with it after the season. If you want to keep a chance to this championship,
mm-hmm.
is in there. You know, just some therapy, some, I think, stretching and maybe
I mean, he did it. Apparently, weight training. Apparently, he did it Thursday before the race. So
yeah, weight training. You know, there's a bunch of stuff you can do to just compensate a little
like
bit.
Like strengthen your quad type deal and all that. Yeah. And what do you think of the bag at Tomac battle?
I don't know. I just find out not too long ago when I was going through. Like internet a little bit, and then I saw there was a story about Baguette talking shit. I'm like, I don't really care.
But not so much even about that. Just what do you think of their battle? Like, who do you like? Baguette's got the red plate. Is Tomac going to figure this out?
Can we call it a battle?
Well, I mean,
we haven't seen a battle.
No, we haven't. Lakewood won moto.
Colorado, he passed him and dropped him, right?
Yeah, he did. Tomac apparently did a bunch of arm work, and his arms were worked.
I heard he did some military thing for his brother or something like that.
I don't know. Yeah. And so, you know, that was really a reason why I guess he couldn't really hold on at Lakewood. But it was impressive at High Point. They both dropped into 155s at one point. You know, they were going for it. And
they were close in that first moto or no, second moto. Second moto, they were close in time, right?
Yeah.
Like Baguette was catching a little bit and then Tomac went for it a little bit and then. I think, you know, I've said it before, I think I like Tomac for the championship, even if he's 11 points behind. I think the Sandy, I don't think Tomac is a very precise rider. You know, he's more like he's more like, show me the line and I'm going to go as fast as I can on this line. Don't make me think about where to go to be fast. You know, I don't think his racing IQ is as good as a Marvin, I say, or something.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're going to get to tracks like Redbud, where you don't have to think about lines, you take the main line, kind of like a Ricky-style type of track, where...
Southwick, Redbud.
The line is already there. The main line, you know where it is.
Yep.
And then you go wide open, and then you're going to be there for 40 minutes, 35 minutes. Then I put my money on Tomac. You know, on tracks like Lakewood... Lakewood, you have to think that, you know, he got hurt a couple of years ago, bad. Yep. So that has to be in his head still.
Sure.
And then Mount Morris is you have to be precise. And I don't think he's not that technical for this type of tracks. You know, rolling the turn and then taking your time in the ruts and everything. And he still did good in one moto.
Yeah.
But when you're going to get to Redbud, Southwick, Butch Creek, when the line is there, just pin the sand berm, then Tomac's going to be there, I think.
Red,
my opinion.
Red, what do you, if you think, if Tomac doesn't fall, he keeps making these mistakes, is he better than the Baguette, do you think?
I kind of thought going into the season that he was, but mm-hmm. I don't know, Baguette surprised me with speed.
Yeah.
And fitness too, but. Even had me kind of going, maybe he will.
I really thought we'd see a Roczen season. He'd lose four motos, five motos. And
I think the biggest question is if Marvin's healthy enough to continue.
Because
I think he's on a roll right now. So if his knee's good, I think he's as much of a title contender as those two.
Marv, Baguette, Tomac, in your eyes, in some order.
Yeah.
See, I think
I'm with Baguette.
I think the Supercross is what we're buying into, you know, think about, I know what it's like from going down to the wire a couple of years, but when you go down to the wire, you give up, you know, you give up weeks, months of outdoor testing,
mm-hmm.
you know, and it's Baguette was never in contention for Supercross,
yeah.
and therefore you get to spend the time and the hours and whatever it is to start prepping, you start, you know, your mind starts switching that direction. I don't think Eli switched to motocross until Saturday night after the race.
The one weekend off, they went on 2 days. But that's about it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's kind of you're half-assing it because you don't want to be hurt.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
don't want to push the limit.
Well, look
at
Justin Hill right now. I think that's what we're seeing with Justin Hill.
And from what I understand, let's not compare Justin Hill and Eli.
No, I'm saying.
Come on.
No, I'm saying. I'm saying Hill should be better. But I think he just had this Supercross title on his mind.
You can't really do that. You can't really talk about this because...
He's a East and a West. I mean, you get weeks and weeks off. He had 8 weeks off.
Even Tomac and the Tomac Baguette, I don't think that's really relevant.
They have set up from last year. The box is the same.
Yeah, but did you see the results from last year with Eli?
Yeah, but he got some seconds.
He was he wasn't that competitive.
Baggett was on a Suzuki too.
Yeah, but that, yeah. There is no Baggett had to test because it
from what I understand,
but
the that 2-day test didn't go to plan. wasn't a great test.
On McCauley or with Baggett? Okay, yeah.
They were kind of left their heads scratching a little bit. And right. Wasn't like he was totally stoked on how that test went anyway. So I just think that, like, I look back at past years and, like, I don't think it's strange to see a Baggett Tomac kind of thing like that. Like, you know, Baggett doing his thing. I mean,
yeah.
was it 13, I think? No, maybe 12 when Baggett won title.
Yeah, 12, I mean, think, yep.
Baggett made those guys look like fools, you know? Like, and, I, you know, we're seeing the same thing. So
right.
It's in there. I don't know that I'm surprised by the speed and the fitness or whatever you want to call it. I think that's all in there. He's shown that before, you know, and same as Eli. I just think that, you know.
I think Baggett's got he's won a championship outdoors too, so
yeah.
I think that
accounts,
pulls
right?
a little bit of weight towards him. So.
I'll tell my guys too, but yeah. And DV, before we went live, you talked about Anderson. You're a fan.
Yeah, like
he goes for it.
No, it's the guy that I like to watch the most. You know, he might not win every, you know, weekend, but he actually tries and he fights and he's aggressive.
He finds creative lines.
You know, like when I see Marvin since the beginning of the year, we haven't seen Marvin at his potential yet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he rode cautious the first race. He should have won second moto. He let, you know, Tomac caught up.
Marv told me he reads your column and he said, well, maybe he'll finally be happy with me.
Yeah.
Maybe DV will finally be happy with me.
Yeah, I heard the video with Dylan too. He reads my French. They both read my French columns and stuff, and talk about it, you know, often. But Marvin first race, second moto, he should have won. He rode like cautious and let Tomac go 1-1. Second race, you know, he let Silly in the back for like 20 minutes, like Van Halen, in his wheel. Second moto, tickle within 3 seconds for 35 minutes. We haven't seen Marvin 100% yet. Or, like, not 100% physically, but he's not charging what he can do. I think he can be way, way, way better. We haven't seen it yet this year. I think he rode better last year outdoors than this season. I don't think he's – even in everybody talk about his first moto in Colorado when he crashed on the start. Mm-hmm. But, you know, Baggett crashed on the start. He was behind Marvin, finished in front.
Yeah.
And yes, he caught up to fourth, but still, he's not quite there yet.
You really follow these races a lot for somebody who doesn't like them. You're like the super fan.
I am. I watched him live. I was supposed to be in Hollywood Saturday.
Rooftop,
early,
bro.
And then, but I stay at home and I watch on the
great radio.
I watch on a computer every moto, and I go. I like to just look at the stats and then where they go. Like,
and do you watch anything?
No, I do. I watch them all. And,
no, you don't.
No, I do.
Really?
Actually, my wife took a video of me watching lap times.
Okay.
The app and on TV. But I don't get into stats. I don't know why. I just
do you want to write a column
honestly,
for Pulpmx?
Stats remind me of ball sports.
Yeah.
And I don't like it. So I don't like stats.
Okay.
But that's what's good about ball
like
sports
facts.
Is stats.
I don't like that.
ERA, OBP, come on.
And for you, Chad. You're bored, right? You're watching them. You're just like, I got them.
Yeah, I mean, I don't believe my wife's listening right now, but yeah, I'm bored. She's, and then not, I just, you know, like I spent so many years racing. I'm currently kind of wanting to race, I guess. The motocross thing, I'm okay. Like, I don't know that I want to be out there riding because it's just like there is a part of me that's, like I've let go of that. Like I don't want to. Like I went to Hangtown and I was happy to watch.
Yeah.
Happy to take it all in. And not be out there. Like no part of me really wanted to be out there. And that may change with the feelings that I have. But right now I don't want to be out there.
But you'll watch them.
But I watch them. You know, like I wake up Saturday mornings and
I'm not surprised. I mean,
you know,
you're still racing. You know?
I watch it on the apps. You know, and I feel like. It kind of sucks because, you know, like, Saturdays I'm not there, you know, like, I'm there, but I'm not there, and I wish that I could turn off and ignore it and, you know, spend the day with the wife and kids, but there's a part of me that's still massively involved, and I enjoy it still, so.
Oh, yeah, maybe start your own team.
No.
I think that'll...
With somebody else's money.
I think he tried it before.
heard that once.
Yeah.
And I think
he seems like he's so much into it. Let's get a team.
I kind of went through the same thing a little bit too, but I think once he knows it's time, then he knows.
Yeah.
And I watch it, and from the time I retired and quit, I never wanted to be out there anymore.
Yeah, I can relate to that with motocross. Like right now, like I love it still. Like I love the sport, but like the motocross thing, like. As much as I want to ride, I want to be involved, watching the racing doesn't do anything for me. Like, right. I'm good. Like, I watch the tracks. The tracks look more horrendous than I've ever seen them. You know, like, that just doesn't do anything for me. Like, I don't want to be out there. Right. So, I'm happy to be a fan and just a
I mean, honestly,
supercross guy.
Sometimes I'll sit there and look. I'm far removed from my riding days, and I suck balls when I rode. But in practice, I'll look at the tracks, and I'll be like, that looks like so much fun to go ride. I haven't thought that about any of these four rounds, like myself, like just as a local rider. I'm like, I would never want to be out on that track right now. No. Like, no way. They look beat down, hellish, no fun to ride. So
yeah, they definitely look tough, man. A lot of ruts. And
just really, probably ruddier than we've ever seen them. Just a lot of a lot of prep before the races, and it just gets one big groove.
Yeah. Absolutely. Pulpmx Show presented by BTOsports.com and Fly Racing. Timmy Ferry on the show tonight, 1997 125 East Coast champion with no wins, but that's okay. Brought to you by RoostMX, everybody.
I really don't care.
No. You clearly don't care because the other day on our group text, you sent a photo of your 95 high point overall winning trophy.
UFO gear?
It's
95, yeah.
It's in a shed.
UFO.
It's in a shed.
UFO. It's in the shed, and it's got a piece of wood on it, or it's on a piece of wood.
Yeah, it's in there.
His overall winning trophy.
How much was the bonus?
Like 25 grand or something?
No.
Not
probably
even
like
that?
10, maybe.
Really?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was low.
We're talking about 95.
I think to win a Supercross.
Not that
like
long before.
You know, in 93, MC Sinisaru deal was $50,000.
He's what?
Is gear deal?
I talked,
93 was 50 grand.
No way.
My championship bonus was only 50.
I did a story with MC.
What,
97?
50 grand?
But even my
might as well like, not ride.
Yeah,
I did it. I didn't win a race.
Might as well not
I didn't even
ride.
Win a race.
Might as well stay home.
I did a story with McGrath this year on Racer X. And when he went, he won 15 of 16 Supercrosses in 96 for Honda. He made almost more money in 97 on the Suzuki, winning. I think he won four.
I think three.
He almost won way more money. That's how much his bonuses were than winning the 15 out of 16. He was saying that Ricky and Chad and James can thank him because right around that 96-7 is when things went drastically up.
Even like not so, even like 90. not 90, even 2002 lights compared to now lights. Like,
yeah.
I think my lights bonuses are maybe 25 grand and like 150 championship, and now they're making like
50 and
like,
a half a million.
Like 50 and a half
is
million
it,
dollars.
Is it 500 grand for
yeah,
TV
like,
Supercross?
Yeah, yes. It's good now.
Title?
Really
yes.
good, yeah.
Holy shit. That's
yeah,
a lot.
That's what I mean. Like,
oh, wow. Also, too, RoostMX, so Cycle Trader Rock River team uses RoostMX. Dean Ferris. Aussie killed it this weekend for the Cycle Trader Rock River team. RoostMX.net to check it all out. Code PULPNATION to save 20%. Whether it's helmet kits, trailer graphics, pitch shirts, custom graphics, T-shirts, whatever, they got a whole PULPNATION section on their website. They're bringing you Tim Ferry, who's currently on his phone right now. All right, everybody, welcome to the show. Let's get some questions from the fans. Lines are full. Paul, what's up, man? How are you?
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Good. What's happening?
I might just get shut down and called stupid, but I'm starting to think that Tomac might be a slight head case when he's an underdog and he's way behind. The dude's flying. He's passing people like he's amazing. When he's close to the points lead or he has the points lead, it's almost like he overthinks everything and he goes slower.
Yeah, but okay. That people have said that, but my comeback to you, Paul, is what about Salt Lake when he was tied with Dunge with the red plate? And came from dead last to win.
Hey, no, I really don't have a solid argument. It's just something that
right.
a thought that has passed through my head. I mean, so I, like I said, I just thought it
what
might
you,
be.
What do you think about that, DV? Some people have said, Tomac can't handle pressure based on New York, based on this outdoor series.
Yeah, I think it's. We have to wait to see if it's coincidence or if it's really something that's gonna, you know, up and over and over.
I mean, he's a 250 Supercross champion. He's a 250 Motocross champion.
The only thing with Tomac that I'm kind of surprised and I don't really have an answer for is when you're leaving New York and you crash and you take 5 minutes to get back going and then you forgot. It seems like your mechanic took your bike and finished the race. It's like Josh Grant is almost like stopping on the track to let you go by, and then you're not able to pass him to gain two more points.
Yep.
Like, what's going on?
That was a weird
ride. That's something I can't explain, because he gets to the front, crash, then he waits forever,
but then
forgot how to ride.
But, Chad, you raced it. It was a hard track to go fast on. It was kind of like Thunder Valley. Like, ruddy and shitty.
Really soft, for sure.
Because he had about three close calls after he picked his bike up.
It was a little bit like Seattle, right? Seattle back in the day.
Seattle was looser. This year, Seattle.
Yeah. Seattle is looser. It was soft. It was loose on top, but it had, like, a never-ending, like, sponginess to it. You know, like, there was no – it seemed like there was no bottom. I don't know. I think that, you know, like, once you're in your groove, that's one thing. And then, you know, obviously – the biggest thing is in New York or New Jersey, the more the fact that the lack of hurry to get back on the bike,
that was weird.
But then, you know, the mistakes after that, I think that, you know, at that point, I feel like he's on his back foot and he knows he's blown it at that point, you know, and I mean.
Like, he lost it mentally, you mean?
He lost it mentally, and I think that personally he'd probably admit to that, but I just think that, I mean, unfortunately, we've all been there. We've all had those rides. It just happened to be the ride that counted the most for him. I think that we'll be interesting to see how he bounces back through the outdoor season.
Yeah, I think the outdoors will kind of tell.
I mean, people are panicking, not panicking, but people on my Twitter feed are like, he's blowing it. He feels the pressure. He's won 3 motos. 3 of them, he's been gone. Just see you later. Like, they're not big battles. Like, I think if he can just figure this thing out, you know, and talking to the Cowie guys after the weekend, they're like, hey, we came in 17 down. We're 11 down now.
It's a win.
And I'm like, well, I guess you got a point, you know?
Yeah.
So,
very good point.
Thanks for the call, Paul. Appreciate it.
Hey, have a great show, guys. Thanks for coming on, everybody.
Tyson, what's going on, man? What's your question for Team Yamaha from 2003, 2005? What a crew, including the mechanics, just phenomenal mechanics. Myself, rookie.
I've got a question for all of you guys I'd like to answer, and it's kind of a nostalgia question, but also a current question. So when you look at Mount Morris, it's evident that MX Sports is trying to switch things up and how they switch up the track. If you were in charge of MX Sports, which track would you take off the circuit, and which old track that used to be on the circuit would you put back on? See if each of you guys could answer that for me.
What do you think, Timmy?
More than anything, what's really off that wasn't on?
Freestone,
Ohio, Binghamton,
Troy, Binghamton,
Steel City.
I don't know. I mean, I did.
I'm good with not going to Pittsburgh.
I like Steel City.
You like Steel City?
Yeah.
Did you win Steel City 1 year?
No.
God, I think every time I've been there, I've cartwheeled.
No, 125, no?
No.
Close?
I just like Steel City.
Yep.
Binghamton, I would do well there, so you always say, I like the track, I do that.
Nice.
But honestly, there's not – yeah, the track –
you're one of the only guys that really loves Unadilla. You always –
I do like Unadilla.
No, Unadilla is cool.
I don't love it, but I think the layout – like, I don't love – actually, I like old school Unadilla than I do new school.
Right.
Like, new school Unadilla blows, I think.
Yeah,
because they want to –
dude, it's like every other track. It's full of woods.
Just slip the grass and then
you literally pick a rut and it's just like it's like slot track racing now.
Red Bud was like, hey, we got this Larocco's Leap. It's a natural, sort of natural jump that's been there for 100 years. Let's put another triple on the other side, a massive 100. Like, why?
Yeah.
Why?
Red Bud was as hot as Carlsbad.
Yeah.
It was dusty, shitty, and then all of a sudden it's same, right, same
so,
track.
So if you ask me, I would
Steel City.
I'd bring Steel City back. I don't know which one I would take away. There's not one that's
Muddy Creek.
I haven't rode Muddy Creek since I was at 1991.
Oh, really? It's been that long? Okay, yeah. I was gonna say,
As a spectator, it doesn't look wide
what
enough,
about
big enough.
You know what? I'll take them off. I don't put anything back on.
You take them all off?
No, I just do like instead of 12 because it sucks anyway.
Just 5.
Just do like Just take four out.
Okay.
Just right. take.
I feel like
you know
should
what?
Put him in charge.
I like. You know
he
what?
Hates motocross.
And then you come back for outdoors.
And then I'll come back.
He
for
hates
outdoors.
Motocross.
Like,
he hates motocross.
But if you don't need 12, well, you know who's gonna be champion at one point. It's like you don't need 35 supercross races. You don't maybe need 17 in 18 weekends.
I think we need 22 supercrosses.
This ridiculous.
Don't bro me.
And then the thing is, this tracks that you know, Glen Helen should go.
No, come on.
Yes.
I don't love it, but I think it's no, you have to.
It shouldn't go. It should whoever's in charge of doing it,
it
just
should go.
Fire him.
Yeah, no, I agree with
and
that.
And then bring like a what your guys
like
track guys, Dream Tracks or whatever their name is.
Or Barnett or something.
Hey, thanks Tyson. Appreciate it. Thanks Tyson.
Yeah, 7-8.
Nash, what's up, Nash?
Gentlemen.
How are you? This is one of our regular callers, Nash.
I remember him.
He's from Jersey.
Oof. Look at that, because Ferry, RRP connection, Rossini Racing Product.
Here we
Jersey.
Go.
That's how the pros do it. Hey, congratulations, Steve, on 300 shows.
It's Thank been you. It's been, really a, it's been phenomenal. I can't believe we made 300.
I can't believe you got these three in City of Hollis and Reedy Billy, and of course.
I mean, it was amazing. They actually to agree to come here. It was pretty, actually, well, what?
You know, that's a testimony, whether they ever admit it out loud, that's a testimony that they appreciate what you do, Steve, and you're passionate about the sport.
I don't know. So I got paid him a ton of money. Anyways, go ahead.
That's all part of it, too, sometimes. I got three simple questions for each guy. Each question is a little different.
Okay.
Chad, you took me back in the time machine when you started talking about people. Like, they're getting – all of us, including myself, are enjoying this Baguette Tomac thing. And I remember back in 2010 when you won Hangtown – and Alessi was popping off about the 9% body fat and the Navy SEAL training. And again, in the past. But I remember seeing
hey, he
your
won on
face.
A 350, too. Like the only time a 350 has ever won in America. It was such a weird Dude. Day.
Listen, I just remember seeing Reed's face when he was saying that stuff. Like, bro, like, are you kidding me? Like, are you kidding me? Because I'm
great.
Pretty dumb. So that's a, who
serious shit
got
going
it.
On with those guys.
my question to Reedy was, who really got him fired up with some trash talking? If that's not it, then who?
Well, Jacksonville 09. I mean, Stu and Chad, it's legendary.
That's the best.
I mean, there's 50 examples of Stu and Chad going at it.
The hand on the neck, all the good stuff.
I mean,
we love it all.
Yeah, Nash, come on. You got to come up with a better question than that.
Atlanta. Atlanta 11 was pretty good.
Atlanta 11.
Atlanta 11. I was in the team manager tower.
I should
clean I was like screaming more than the fans. I was like, I love this shit.
How did you not get fined for that?
It really wasn't.
It wasn't that bad.
It wasn't that bad. No, it really wasn't.
It wasn't bad.
Like it wasn't like. I
wouldn't find him.
It wasn't DV.
Wyndham.
No, nothing. Nothing. No. Come on, you can't compare.
Oh, I need to watch this
like,
again.
The only reason I crashed is because I went in and. Didn't like right. I actually should have went in got the job done but I was actually too nice and that's why I went down.
They crash at like 2 miles an hour.
Yeah,
come on.
Literally.
Okay.
I love it. Ferry, what's your first memory of Steve? Were you like, who is this guy and why is he working?
Actually, I can picture it to this day. Him,
wow.
Him walking looking for him and thinking he was
99.
Thinking he was somebody different than he was. He came out like all right.
Yeah, 99.
Let's go to the track.
99, I came back from Germany. I got hired to be your mechanic. Die split for Yoshimura Suzuki road race team.
Yep.
And then, you thought I was Alan Terlecki? Was
yeah, I
it?
Think so. And I saw you, and I was just like, Dave Die kept saying.
Listening. We're
Dave Die says, oh, you'll know him as soon as you see him. I'm like, okay. Usually I know everybody by face, but I didn't know him.
Steve, why can't Dave Guy come on the show? For years, Kenny taunted him.
I texted
Chad,
him.
You got the star
No, I texted him. He said that he would come on.
He's
and
come
I said,
on one time, and then we asked him a controversial question or something. He said, my phone's breaking up, and he hung up.
Like when he fell asleep driving the truck?
We asked him, well, he's looking for Alessi's. We asked him what Tony was like or something. He said, my phone's breaking up, click. I mean, it's Dave Dye, right?
Hey, maybe he'll call in tonight in honor of the 300. DB, final thing. You got all the power in the world. You got the magic wand. What would you physically change to the – I know that you hate motocross, but not a big fan. What would you change to the track prep or the surfaces of the track for the Nationals?
I would leave natural terrain.
Yes.
Everywhere. No more sand, no more wood. Amen. Back in the day, it was like wood chips. Like, they killed Binghamton with wood chips, for example. Mm. For me, they killed Redbud with sand. They killed Engtown with same thing with, you know, sand and Brussels. Overdoing. The thing is, they all the promoters out there, but maybe Bud's Creek and Redbud, or maybe Millville, but let's say those three tracks, like the nine other tracks, they want to look like those three tracks. And that's the big, they want a big jump. They want sand rollers. They want, you know, berms. Stop doing that. Just leave. It's like, you're not going to bring clay to Southwick, right? So why would you, would you bring sand, a truck log of sand on an all track? It doesn't make sense. And then there's too much prep. There's too much water, lines. And then, back in the day, like what I liked they were doing is now you can't really do it because there is two time practice, but there was no time practice
when it
put A bales on the inside for first practice. So we'll do like outside lines. And then I think it was a little better. And it wasn't as deep back then. And it seems like it's going deeper and deeper. It's more rutted.
It's getting worse.
And then you get in one groove and then you can't get out. You can't go wherever you want. It sucks.
Timmy, you've been racing since 1970. Seriously, though, how different are the national tracks, right? Like, it's amazing.
Yeah, it is. And when you said natural, I rode at Unadilla when it was all grass for the GP.
Yeah.
I did a support class. It was me, Guy Cooper, and it just had ribbons.
on the grass.
Guy Cooper.
I forget how old.
I didn't think you were that old.
I would follow Guy Cooper around the whole track. But
no,
it was all grass, and it was this tall. But, man, the dirt was so good.
Guy Cooper.
And it was no big jumps. I love Redbud, but I'm not a fan of La Rocco's Leap. I think it's the dumbest jump on the circuit.
Why?
It's a little better now. They finally built the landing.
When you lose your car, but the landing.
Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
The
car is not going to blow off. We got these special glue.
Don't worry. We fixed it, Jack.
God.
I just don't think a jump that blows your carburetor off or breaks your wheels is...
Right.
It's not necessary. Obviously, anybody could jump the thing if you hold it wide open.
No, wait. 1 year with you, I was your mechanic. You never jumped it to the first lap in the motor.
I didn't want to jump it. I still don't want to jump it.
Oh, my God.
It is better now. Oh,
you know, the first year I did it.
Nash, thanks, buddy.
I love Redbud.
Thanks, Nash. Go get him. Thanks.
See ya.
The first one, I did not jump it first practice. The first year I went to Redbud. And my dad.
What about on 252 strokes? How gnarly it was.
Yeah, 252 stroke.
You couldn't
and
do it.
And my dad says, "You're a pussy. Just jump that thing." I'm like, "Dude, that thing is wide open." I'm like, "I'm scared." I'm like, "Just, you know, fucking jump it next practice." I'm like, "Dude, I'm scared." I'm like, "I don't know." And then back then we could like cut the track and stuff.
Yeah.
Remember?
Right.
And
you'd
then
go to the fence.
No. I was coming this way from the other side, and then I see Windham going to La Rocco's Leap. I'm like, "Oh, that's it." I jump behind Windham and I turn and I go, I do like what he does, just behind him, and then I jumped it. It was nothing really, but that was maybe like all the way until 2000. That's maybe the biggest jump I ever jumped.
The only thing cool about that jump is when Emig would call it the parking lot jump.
Yes.
La Rocco's Leap. I love that. I would just laugh at the TV every time.
How about Bob's jumping it on 25s? Like just pulling up the front end.
Was it O2 or O3?
We did it. I did it. I think I did it twice, and I've never pulled up so hard in like till this day.
So your fifth tap.
And we did it.
Fold, I think.
And that was like DV said. Like that was before we had time practice and stuff. So you could like there. I just remember one guy did it. I didn't even remember who did it, but like. I actually think it was Burner, because Burner was living back there with Larocco, and he had done it on a practice day. So then next minute, like, Salads and all those guys were all, like, on the fence, just, you know, all the way on the fence and then under the track and then doing it. And I'm like, why are we doing this? You're like, that's not the line.
I think Travis did it in maybe 2000, 2001 from the parking lot. They opened the gate
from the parking lot.
No, they opened the gate. There's a gate right here.
I did it from the track, and it scared me.
I would rather jump something wide open than to not know how hard to hit it.
Burp, burp, burp.
I don't like that.
All right, everybody. Tim Ferry, Chad Reed, David Villeman, BTOsports.com, and Fly Racing. Let's go to the BTOsports.com Tweet It Travis segment.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you this important bulletin from
BTOsports.com.
Here's the Tweets of Travis.
BTOsports.com, nation's leading retailer for anything you need for your bike or body, quad or UTVs or dirt bikes, whatever they got. Premier Sports for motocross parts and apparel for well over a decade. Use the code PulpMX when you call or check in. I'll put PulpMX in the check-in line as well. That'll work. And show 300, everybody. So thanks for listening. These are questions submitted to you to the three guests on Twitter. And we're just going to ask them throughout the night instead of doing one regular segment because we got so many. So, all right, Marks, go ahead. Let's ask each guy one.
All right, Chad, we'll start with you. This is from Tanner Hall. Are there any riders you hate now since you started playing fantasy?
Oh.
you won 2 weeks ago. You won the whole thing, right? Our group.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Truman said you won.
Did I?
Yeah.
He didn't tell me that part. He only sends me the stuff when I suck. But he actually was really worse bad today. I mean, this past weekend. I'm a hater on it, actually. I didn't love it. Like, I just don't – like, you're playing a game and you're, like, you're not betting on the good guys. Like, I want to play a game where I'm betting on good guys.
No, you got to – no.
Like, I'm going down the list and I'm like, you know, like, anyone in the top 20, I don't even look at him. I'm like, okay, yeah. So who's 20 through 30 – and unfortunately, I don't know any of them. And so, yeah, like, I don't know them by name. I just know, like, this number. Like, dude, yeah. What's up? And then, he quits, and I'm pissed off. And it's just – but anyway, yeah, no, I don't hate anyone, actually.
All right, there we go.
I hate Dan Truman because he got me into it.
Yeah. All right, next question.
Timmy, this one's from Kurt Lucas. Who was the best mechanic you ever had?
Oh. You motherfucker. You
great know, question,
you know,
bro.
You know what you better say.
Williams, for sure.
Oh, Williams, for sure.
Mechanic, yeah.
Come on.
Dude.
In 99, I'm changing
actually,
suspension.
Actually, Lee was pretty good, too.
Lee?
So my third?
Mechanics.
Made a podium. Nah, BK's probably third.
Oh, BK was pretty good, too.
Yeah.
He was the only one that could do that.
He was the only one that could jet our bikes.
Yes, that four-stroke.
As soon as he left, our bikes went to shit.
Please. Thanks, Mark. Thanks for asking that.
You're very welcome.
Yeah.
So you're fourth, strong top five.
I don't know if I'm fourth. We just named.
You were actually Mathis until I'm at an outdoor national and somebody asked you for your autograph and not me. And they just keep going.
That wasn't.
Even if you lost the front caliper or Unadilla.
With the caliper. After that was BK.
You that won, was BK.
But it broke.
Was it?
I won the first moto. Or
you won the first moto, right?
No, I won the second moto. That busted out the first moto or something. Yeah.
No. You won the first moto. Then it busted the second moto.
That was BK?
That was BK.
That wasn't his fault, though.
It was not his fault.
The rock broke it completely off.
Exactly. We're using those beryllium ones.
I never had any bike failures with you, though.
I did.
Yeah,
I did.
I did.
Almost killed me.
Here we go.
Almost killed me.
One day I left his front caliper loose.
I'm sure you guys were there.
Probably.
Yeah. You know,
my bad.
You know,
I wasn't there because I was hurt. That's why he was working on your bike.
Yeah.
What else did you break on my bike?
Found a plug on my bike.
Your bike broke. Not my fault, but the ignition went out at Southwick. Like, you were like third or fourth late in the moto. And it broke at the furthest part of the track. I had to push it all the way from like the top. Remember when you jumped up on top and made a left?
Not really.
Okay. All right. Well, that's where your bike broke. All right. Next question.
DV. I lost my spot.
Oh.